decision on sports development.
I think what the council's actually saying is that on page 27 it says replacing the playing pitches can be scored through section 106.
Yeah.
As there's already a provision to another application for additional playing fields, football playing fields, that is.
Yeah.
Okay, Matthew, do you want to just explain? It doesn't need to be football playing fields.
It may not be football pitches. It could be some sort of other sports facility. So that's what we're asking for the contribution towards.
Yeah, that's fine. I do have a second question. A note on page 25 that noise survey was carried out from Monday to Friday. I'm in the factory again 7 days a week. Can we have assurances that a full noise survey covering the 7 days a week is carried out before full applications received?
Thank you, and through you, Chair. Yes, we have conditioned calculations and designs for the houses to guarantee that the sound levels night time and during the day, 7 days a week, are really satisfactory and achieved for the comfort of the residents, and also to reduce the risk of any impact on the existing factories. And any calculations provided would have to be supported by robust evidence. So we are taking into account the possibility of night time delay occurring at the factories, which we don't think would stand by the definition.
Cheers, Joe. You did mention that a large part of this is outlined in planning permission, so there needs to be questions in court in a subsequent application. But given the size of the building, should there not be a construction plan put in place? Is that part of this? Also, given that it's a high flood risk area, has there been any move to make properties more robust against flooding?
We can certainly add a construction management plan if members felt that that was something to add at this stage, or it could be added at a reserved matters stage, because this outline is only seeking approval of the access at this point. So the scale, landscaping, appearance, and there is a condition on already. Condition 16 deals with construction management. So we've got that condition. What was the other question?
It's outlined in the left that, but given that it's an outline for living areas, has anything been done to ensure that the materials use the fibrous contains of fluids?
There are a number of conditions contained in the 30 or so at the back of the agenda, which deals specifically with the issue of putting in sustainable and drainage systems. So we are satisfied that the scheme can be developed without increased risk of flooding on site or in the wider area. So that they are conditioned, it's all dealt with every entity, and if flooding is successful, possible to the application as well.
And for the avoidance
of that covers service water as well. Can I take Ian? Just to pick up on the point that Councillor Johnson mentioned, in terms of replacing sports facilities, the report states that the applicants have agreed to, they're willing to enter into a 106 agreement to provide improvements to existing playing fields.
the applicant is prepared to offer 30 affordable units, which I think that's what that tells us, which is fair, and has put some case forward. But can we be assured, and I noticed when we were zooming in to see how many houses there actually were, there's a range of housing being proposed, from flats through, I guess, to three or four bedroom houses. Can we be assured that the affordable element won't just be 30 flats, and that the affordable element will at least reflect the affordable need that we have in terms of two or three bedroom houses? I don't know whether that needs to be conditioned or whether that would be a given, given the number that we're talking about. Final point on highways. I know what's said in the report about 150 AM, 175 PM on Pasture Road. Has any assessment been done actually of the impact on Morton Cross? Because it strikes me that's a roundabout that's, if not at capacity, down there at capacity. And the bulk, especially the bulk of the vehicles will probably be turned towards Morton Cross to access the motorway as opposed to towards to access Wallasey. Let me tell you, anything Morton Cross, it seems to be absolutely chock block with traffic. I'm concerned about the impact of another 100 cars throughout the day on that. If an assessment hasn't been done, it strikes me before we reach full application, that an assessment should be done to see whether, again, we need to undergo some of the improvements to make improvements on that.
As I said, this is at our planning stage, so there is a significant amount of work that still needs to be done in terms of the final layout on the site, where the
construction of three dwellings on this spot. The proposals involve demolition of the existing dwelling and its replacement with a new dwelling, together with two further dwellings at the rear of the plot. The scheme has been amended to reduce the number of units by one, resulting in a development that would be more appropriate to the size of the plot. At this stage, access and layout will be approved, leaving scale, appearance and landscaping for further approval at the matter stage. Access to the site will be via Barker Road, giving access to the